probably happened about 6 to 8 months back. So just as most of you are sharing, like the advantage or the disadvantage of people not connecting with each other is this about, no, I think it happened in KPCA layout on Sajapur Road. So one night you find a lot of houses, the shoes are missing. I think many of you have heard about
yes.
it. Yeah. And it's about 2 to 3 lakhs worth at least on one night, they, about 5 to 6 people. Now the next day, very next apartment, next night, the same thing repeats there. About 4 to 5 lakhs worth shoes missing. Now this, now since we are all, we don't even come to know what has happened at the next neighborhood. Now something like, you know, when you have got a dedicated number like sir is saying, and we are on a WhatsApp group, we can definitely keep sharing these incidents so that, you know, this can be prevented from further spreading to other communities, and definitely it will work in a big way. And what we should do as people is that, and representative from MCs, is that once we reach back, learn this and then try to implement it there. Connect with other MCs, the communities, and presidents or secretary, whatever it is, at least once in a 2 month or once in a quarter, meet up and discuss what is happening. And definitely, as sir said, have a group of all these communities together. And probably your product, which is the gatekeeper, also must have some feature where this any kind of flashes, I mean flash news, can be shared across all these applications, which should be more effective. Yeah.
I have seen, being a member of one of the community, I have seen that I am added to another group which is called as Belandur Apex without me being knowing about it. Is that something which is initiated by ADA team? Because I see that all the related or nearby MC members are part of it already. So is that something which you are... Yes.
Then bubble up there, right? So that is something we have in place. We are looking at how best to, execute it so people are more aware and visual.
Yeah.
The biggest challenge is that management committees change in every apartment complex. So even if you form a federation, you do not know who are the current people. So as and when in ADA, management committee changes, it shows up in the Apex level app also.
Yeah. So I mean, from a technology perspective, you can easily find out from your records that who is the moderator or whoever
that's
it is.
That's what is being done.
Yes. So, but I mean, I saw that, but no activities has been done,
yes,
anything.
I can just add that I'm one of the admins with GNME in Belandur Apex. The reason is we also wanted to come up with, within Belandur Forum, we probably video part of that before. We wanted to come up with a policy of what we need to keep, the scope of the help, etc. Instead of just having yet another group. And
yeah.
Coming, which is not from verified agency, we can probably ask them to drop that. very good concern, but it is a more complex issue also, because the verification for everything, that may be for security guards or delivery boys, workers in the hotel and all, generally now it is being done by the particular and concerned people. Even hotel people are insisting now for verification, background verification, for security guards and for domestic aides and all. Many people are insisting now to get police verification done. But the point is, even after getting police verification, the tendency of human being is anytime he can commit crime for the first time. So we can verify his back antecedents. A 20-year-old or 21-year-old, 23-year-old boy, we can verify his antecedents, but at any time he may tend to commit crime again. But with all these concerns, the increasing activity of our society is making more and more complex problems. So we keep on we keep on watching one another, it will become a chain again. So we'll appoint security guard, we'll have one more person to check the security guards, then one more person to verify and all. So this is where this chain will go. So as far as possible, all these things may be because of our slackness and laziness also. Because when we are living in an apartment or a community, we can have a common place where when we order food or whatever something comes, I will come and pick from there, till there a person come and drop it. You can order for food or a delivery boy, pizza boy or anybody comes. You have a common place, go there and pick up. You know, you have all of us, we have phone numbers, everything. While coming, he will call you. We can go and pick up there. Yes, better. No, when you are thinking about safety, better than increasing this chain, we can do that very simple way. Oh, if he is a very senior person, if he cannot walk out, he cannot walk out of the house. If he is a child, he or she cannot walk out of the house and take it because of any other reason. They can tell their security guards, my food has come, keep there or let that boy come to my house. And give the, it is in extreme cases, not in all cases. As long as we increase our laziness, this will give us.
I think that's a fantastic point, because it's all about how do we improve the processes and the touch point. And one of the things that we observed in our research also is the high touch, low touch, and how do we avoid that. But answering specific to your question, sir, we also work with a lot of companies and large number of companies all over India. And so it's about pre-employment, during employment, and post-employment check as well. So if somebody is coming and claiming to be, I'm coming from, let's say, Roadrunner, with that number and identity, you would be able to see immediately whether he is from Roadrunner or not. So that comes up in the solution that we provide. So as a visitor, you don't have to ask for the details. The details will come automatically with verified details, which are already pre-verified. So the whole process becomes much more secure. Otherwise, what happens, somebody was saying that I work for, and I give you an example as well, I work for a company, let's say Roadrunner, I have the T-shirt, I leave the job in the morning, come in the night, and can do anything, and we keep thinking about this guy being a Roadrunner. So those are the things that we realize, and we sorted it out through our integration with all the delivery ecosystem, for example, right? So we. No, I think basically the whole idea, as sir said rightly, is one is that improving the processes. The second is that ensuring that we have as an ecosystem the central point of verifying the right information rather than letting it happen by itself.
Thank you. Thank you, Anupama. Thank you, Narasimurthy sir. Thank you, Praveen and Caroline, for coming here. Okay.
Yeah, ma'am. This is more of an observation. If you see a lot of delivery boys, you know, nowadays who come from Flipkarts, etc., they send a message with the details of who is going to deliver with their phone number, so on and so forth. I think it can be incorporated as part of a process you know, more from a regulatory perspective, that this needs to be shared. And then we are more equipped, you know, to identify the person. What can also be done, and you know, I've been trying to do this, whenever, you know, especially from any financial agency or, you know, banks, people come, they carry an identity card. They should also carry an identity card, you know, the ID number of which can be sent as an SMS for us to verify. This is just an idea.
All right, thank you. Thank you so much for coming. And I hope the session, I mean, they are there here. You can network with them during the network break.